The first Superman cartoons comprised of 17 animated Technicolor short films. They were released by Paramount Pictures from 1941 to 1943. The first 9 cartoons were produced by Fleischer Studios, which is the name the cartoons commonly go by, the Fleischer Supermans, even though in 1942, Fleischer Studios was dissolved and reorganized as Famous Studios. Famous Studios produced the final 8 shorts, even though they're collectively sometimes referred to as the Fleischer Supermans. Popeye fans will be familiar with these two studios, as they also went through the same period of transitions. A private joke, sometimes I like to call the Fleischer Studio Popeye pre-crisis Popeye and the King Features Popeye post-crisis Popeye. Superman first appeared in Action Comics number 1 on June 30th, 1938. He was created by Jerry Siegel and Joe Shuster. The first cartoon in the series was self-titled Superman, which was released on September 26th, 1941. The voice of Superman was provided by Bud Collier, who also provided the voice of Superman during the Adventures of Superman radio series.
This is a job
in 1966,
Superman.
Collier would return to the role of Superman in the Filmation animated series entitled The New Adventures of Superman. The first 9 Fleischer cartoons had more elements of a science fiction or fantasy nature, as they involved the Man of Steel fighting robots, giant dinosaurs, meteors from outer space, and other outlandish perils. The first cartoons also introduced the classic opening line, which was later adopted by the Adventures of Superman radio series and in the live-action television series.
Faster than a speeding bullet, more powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. This amazing
Once produced by Famous Studios, the final 8 cartoons in the series dealt more with aspects of World War II and had Superman combating the Japanese Axis forces. The final 8 also continued the use of the now classic exclamation from the radio series. Originally, in the comic books, Superman had the ability to leap an eighth of a mile, as opposed to flying under his own power like we're normally used to today. When making the cartoons, the Fleischer brothers found it difficult to keep animating him leaping, so when Superman was adapted to the cartoons by the Fleischer Brothers studio, he also gained the ability of true flight. In the comics, his abilities gradually increased. He was able to leap farther and farther while performing greater aerodynamic stunts. However, while some descriptions had Superman skyrocketing through the air suggesting flight, others had him swimming Lois Lane by rowboat suggesting that he did not have the power of true flight. By 1943 in Action Comics 60, the comics explicitly refer to Superman as a being who could fly like a bird, and by Action Comics 65, there's no question that Superman's flying from Metropolis to Washington, D.C. Superman's shield first became a pentagon in the Fleischer and Famous Superman shorts. Originally, in the comics, it was a triangle. The shield in the animated shorts was black, with a red S outlined with white, although it was on occasion outlined with yellow. This would later influence the design of the Superman from the series Kingdom Come, where an aged Superman sported an S-like symbol against a black background and a red pentagon. This is reflected also in the aftermath of the Our Worlds at War storyline, in which the Superman comics had him wearing the black and red variant to signify his mourning of the losses during the war. Superman, the Fleischer animated short, was nominated for the 1942 Academy Award for Best Short Subject, Cartoons. Even though Superman lost to Lend a Paw, a Pluto cartoon from Walt Disney Productions, it still had an awesome influence on the animators of today. This is readily reflected in the animation style of Batman the Animated Series. These cartoons are great and deserve all the praise they receive. If you've never seen them, you're in for a rare treat.